Hello and welcome to episode 5 of the Gameplaycasts Warhammer 40k Miniatures Challenge. With the basis of 2 of the 3 miniatures done, I move on to my D&D wizard. Is it Leviosa or Levy Loser? This one's a bit of a personal vanity project, but it's also the smallest of the models. I'm point blank refusing to buy any more paints at this point, so given the now fairly large collection I've accrued, I should have more than enough colours. Firstly, let me remind everyone of the concept art that I used for my D&D character. If anyone's interested, my DM used this in combination with a website called Hero Forge to create the model files, which we then bought for a small fee. I think it was about $5 or something, $7. And we then used a 3D printer here in the UK to print out this customized miniature. Hero Forge is a really handy site for anyone wanting to create custom miniatures. So I'll leave a link in the description. Let's get down to business. Initially, I wanted to give my wizard the traditional Merlin-style blue robes that you see in all the old-school Merlin-esque tales. However, since my character has blue hair, and I went to the trouble of buying a specific shade of paint just for the blue hair, it's probably a bit too much blue. So after much deliberation, I settled on grey for the main body, with some light blue undertones. Thankfully, from the Primaris Marine, doing it in ultramarine colours and buying the full suite of highlighting colours, I have plenty of lighter shades and can obviously mix up and match as required. So it's all good. I already have Retributor Gold and Snakebite Leather for a spellbook, and since I went crazy on the lava base for my Demon Prince, I have all the colours needed to make a cool, fiery spell effect. Total side note, but as I decided to get back into the hobby, I knew I had a stash of items in my parents' garage, so I went back and salvaged them. And believe it or not, some of my original Warhammer paints have survived the 20-year status in my parents' garage. I estimate just over a 50% attrition rate, but the marvellous old-school colours that you're seeing on the screen now survived, and after a quick mix with some extra water, they have been assimilated into my collection. Finally, something came up Milhouse in this entire series. Equally, I seem to have everything I need, plus a few extra options. I've decided on a paint scheme, so it's painting time!
Dwarfing time! Dragon sword!
Heresy grows from idleness.
Would you look at that? With the right tools, paints, and some practice, I think I'm actually getting better. Or maybe because this model's so small, I feel awesome because it was so much quicker. Let's assume the form. As you can see, these are just rough base coats, though you don't have to wait long as the grand reveal for all three models is coming in the next video. Episode 6, Soldier, Demon, Wizard. Very excited to show you the final results and let you decide if my models pass or fail. So to give you the breakdown of this model, I think the first thing I painted was his skin. As always, I used Gulliman's flesh, then I used Talisar Blue for his hair, before moving on to the larger areas. The idea here being, if I got paint on any of the details, I could always paint over them in white and then paint them, whereas if I do these bits first and then get it wrong, as in I get dark paint on the details, I'll probably have to do this again, but then I'll also have to spend the time getting the base for the detail right too, so in the long run I'll probably lose more time. Anyway, for his cape I used some Black Templar. I added a second coat later as this wasn't quite dark enough. I used Celestra Grey for his robes, as well as the cobbles on the base, and then finished his robes off with some Kalgar Blue, just for the inner trim bits at the bottom there. Once the main body of work was done, I added a few details in, starting with Spirit Stone Red for the potion bottle. For his belt, book, and shoes, I used Snakebite Leather. I also added some Wraithbone as the base for the pages and the scroll. I'm going to add an Agrax Earthshade or a Nuln Wash to that later. I also used some green I had on hand for his hairband, and then undercoated the fire with some Bad Mood Yellow from my salvage. Finally, I added some Agrax Earthshade to the base to give some depth to the cobblestones.
And with that, I'll draw this video to a close. Finite incantatum. Sorry, Harry Potter nerd. Don't worry, as it's not long to wait now, as the grand reveal for all three series miniatures is coming up in the next video. Exciting times. So what do you think? Is this miniature going to turn into a metaphoric Fleur Delacour? Or is it a Gregory Goyle? Please leave a comment if you've enjoyed the series so far, and please give me your suggestions on how I might improve my content going forward. I've been Tim from Gameplaycasts. Peace out, and thanks for watching.